Hello everybody and welcome to this video. My name is Haley and today we're going to talk about manipulating fractions. So you've probably clicked on this video because you, like many other people, dislike fractions and don't like dealing with them. However, you are in a class that requires you to work with them and you think you should probably figure it out. Hopefully by the end of this video you won't be as afraid of them anymore. Let's start off by defining some vocabulary. You have probably heard these terms thrown around, but you might not know or remember what they mean. The numerator is the top half of the fraction. The denominator is the bottom half of the fraction. An improper fraction is a fraction where the numerator is larger than the denominator. A mixed number is a whole number plus a proper fraction. A multiple is a number that can be divided by another number without a remainder. Factors are numbers we can multiply together to get another number. The least common multiple is the lowest quantity that is a multiple of two or more given numbers. The greatest common factor is the largest positive integer that divides each of the numbers. For multiplying fractions, you just multiply across. If we had 9 over 17 times 3 over 4, that would be 9 times 3 over 17 times 4, which gives us 27 over 68. And since that doesn't reduce, that's going to give us our answer. And it's the same for when there are variables. If we had x over 5 times 2x squared over 3, that would be x times 2x squared over 5 times 3. And that would give us our answer of 2x cubed over 15. For both adding and subtracting fractions, we need to find a common denominator. By finding a common denominator, I mean that we want to end up with both fractions having the same denominator. We can do this by either finding the least common multiple, LCM, or multiplying the denominators together. Multiplying the denominators together and using that as your common denominator will always work. You just might have to do more reducing to get simplest form. Let's start with an example. Say that we had 2/3 plus 5/6. Let's go ahead and do the problem using the least common multiple and by multiplying together. To find the least common multiple, start with a smaller number and start listing out multiples. Basically count by that number. For 3, we get 3, 6, 9, 12. We don't have to count very far before we hit the least common multiple, which in this case would be 6. This means our common denominator is going to be 6. Now we have to figure out what to multiply both sides by to get the common denominator. 5, 6 is fine since the denominator is already 6. But we need to multiply 2/3 by 2 to get 6 on the bottom. We can't just multiply the bottom by 2 since that would change the value of the fraction. Instead, we multiply by 2 over 2 since that's equal to 1, and multiplying by 1 doesn't change the value of what you're multiplying by. Therefore, we have 2/3 times 2 over 2 plus 5 over 6 equal to 4 over 6 plus 5 over 6, and that equals 9 over 6. When we simplify by dividing the top and bottom by 3, we get 3 halves. Depending on your teacher, they might be okay with having the number be an improper fraction. Other times they might want it to be a mixed number. If they're fine with having an improper fraction, you can stop after reducing to simplest form, and in this case your answer would be 3 halves. To write as a mixed number, see how many times the denominator goes into the numerator, and put the remainder on top of the denominator. 2 goes into 3 one time evenly, and 3 minus 2 gives us a remainder of 1. Our mixed number will be 1.5. If all of that seems complicated, you can just multiply the denominators together to get a common denominator. In this case, the common denominator would be 3 times 6, which is 18. Multiplying both fractions, we get 6 over 6 times 2/3 plus 5 over 6 times 3 over 3. Using the same logic as before, we can't just multiply by 6 or 3, so we have to multiply by 6 over 6 and 3 over 3 to get 18 on the bottom. And that equals 12 over 18 plus 15 over 18, and adding those together we get 27 over 18. Simplifying, we get 27 divided by 9 over 18 divided by 9, and that reduces to 3 halves. So as an improper fraction, we get 3 halves. And as a mixed number, we get 1.5. Now, what if we weren't sure what the denominator is? For example, if we had 4 over x minus 2 over 5. We would do the exact same method as before, we just can't simplify quite as much. Our common denominator is going to be 5x since we just multiply the denominators together. then 4 over x times 5 over 5 plus 2 over 5 times x over x equals 20 over 5x plus 2x over 5x, and that gives us 20 plus 2x over 5x, and that's going to be our answer since we can't simplify anymore. Dividing fractions can be a little trickier. You don't need a common denominator, but you do need to be aware of what you're actually doing. You might have heard of the phrase keep change flip for dividing fractions, but why does that work? Let's say we are doing 30 divided by 2 over 5. This is saying the same thing as 30 equals 2 over 5 times x, where x is what we are trying to find. So, to solve for x, we multiply by 5 and then divide by 2. So then we get 5 times 30 equals 2x, and 5 times 30 gives us 150. So we get 150 divided by 2 equals x, and 150 divided by 2 is 75. So x equals 75. This is the same process as 30 times 5 over 2, since we get 30 times 5 over 2. 30 times 5 is 150, and 150 divided by 2 is 75. So instead of having to set up the process every time, we can simply say keep, change the sign, flip the fraction. Now that we have the basics of fractions down, let's take a look at solving a fractional expression. For example, 9x over 4x plus 5 plus 8x squared over 6x plus 5. From our basic rules, we know that we need to multiply the denominators together to get the common denominator. Our common denominator is 4x plus 5 times 6x plus 5. So we have 9x over 4x plus 5 times 6x plus 5 over 6x plus 5 plus 8x squared over 6x plus 5 times 4x plus 5 over 4x plus 5. And rewriting that a little bit, we just get 9x times 6x plus 5 over 4x plus 5 times 6x plus 5. And same with 8x squared times 4x plus 5 over 4x plus 5 times 6x plus 5. Now we can simplify by distributing the 9x and 8x squared respectively. So we get 54x squared plus 45x plus 32x cubed plus 40x squared all over 24x squared plus 20x plus 30x plus 25. And now we can combine like terms to get our simplified answer. So we get 32x cubed plus 94x squared plus 45x all over 24x squared plus 50x plus 25. So we still use the same rules, it just looks a little bit more complicated when you add variables in. Well, that's it for this video. If you want more practice problems, I have some in the transcript located in the description of this video. If you want to check out what else the Learning Center offers, we have links to our website and all the other good stuff in the description as well. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a good rest of your day.